9,000 volts.
Rectifier to 9,000.
Good. Now switch the oscillator from negative to positive.
Switch the oscillator. Grandpa?
Yes?
I don't mean to seem nosy, but what's the purpose of this machine?
Purpose of the... I'm going to take electricity out of the air and store it. We'll never have to pay another light bill. I'm going to try and attract the lightning right now. I got it!
Herman, I think you ought to take that toaster to the store and have it fixed right.
Now, Lily, dear, they don't call me Handy Herman for nothing. Oh, this toaster fixed and 3 shakes of a cat of nine tails.
Hey, Pop, we have a new English teacher at school, and I've got to write a composition. Would you help me?
Just as soon as I finish this toaster for your mother.
Now, I'm going to transfer the stored electricity in this machine and connect it to the house wires. Now, go back there and name the controls.
There we go. About to do it.
The subject of your school composition, Eddie?
My parents, an average American family.
Fine, dear. When your father comes too, I'm sure he'll be able to help you with it.
Is it 2 or 3 tablespoons of vinegar you put into sour apple pie?
Better put 3, dear. We don't want it to be tasteless.
I thought Eddie'd be down here to lick the spoon.
No. He went right up to his room after school. He's really working on that composition.
I know. He's been asking all kinds of questions.
I think it'll be good. I bet when his teacher reads about this family, her eyes will really pop out. Our dodo bird roast is coming along fine. You know, they're getting very scarce on the market these days.
Isn't it wonderful we can cook our whole meal on our own electricity? Well, now, this is one invention of Grandpa's that really has worked.
Well, at least so far. I think a little cactus juice dressing will be fine for the salad. I'd better tell Grandpa his electricity is off. Oh. Your stupid electricity machine isn't working. And we're trying to fix dinner.
Oh, Lily, please, I'm working on it. You'll have all the electricity you want in just a minute.
Well, he said he's fixing it. But I wish he'd waited a while before he wrote that nasty letter to the electric company. Here we go! Oh, that Benjamin Franklin was a piker.
Oh, there we are. Everything's running again.
Grandpa. Well, I guess it's cold rhinoceros tongue sandwiches again tonight.
Hey, Mom, what happened?
Our dinner just flew out the window.
Oh, boy. I need exciting stuff like this for my composition. This family was beginning to sound awfully dull.
Oh, bury me not.
Free.
In a narrow grave, just 6x3. Oh, bury me not on the lone prairie.
It's nice to get together and sing those old fun songs.
Yeah, they just don't write them the way they used to.
Aunt Lily.
Yes, Marilyn?
Eddie has an announcement to make.
Oh, wonderful. I'll bet your new set of fangs just came in.
It's even neater than that. I finished my school composition.
Whoa!
Good.
Oh, and he's so proud of it. He wants to read it to us.
Hey, good. Eddie, read the part about the first, because that's the best.
No, Eddie. Read the part I helped you with.
Wait.
Tut, 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 family. Let's have none of these petty jealousies. Eddie will start with the beginning, which just so happens to be all about his wonderful father.
My Parents, an Average American Family by Edward Wolfgang Munster. I have the most wonderful family in the whole world, and we all live in a mansion on Mockingbird Lane. It is a neat place. All the grass is weeds and the trees is dead.
Well, he does have a flair for the language.
And don't forget to copy it off later in blood. Remember, neatness counts.
My father is the head of the house.
This is the good part.
My father is a handsome man about 9 feet tall who has a green complexion and steel bolts in his neck. Stork did not bring my father. He was made in Germany, in a laboratory. He was built by a Dr. Frankenstein, whose hobby was putting together do-it-yourself people kits.
Well, go ahead, Eddie. I want our principal, Mr. Bradley, to hear all of this.
My mother is over 400 years old, and right now she is alive. Although there were many times when she wasn't. My grandfather was born in Transylvania, where he was known as Count Dracula. He did nothing but night work, and always got home by sunrise to flake out in his marble bed. I have a pet, Spot, who breathes fire and smoke and eats manhole covers, telephone poles, whatever happens to wander into the neighborhood. I also have a girl cousin, Marilyn. She is not pretty like the rest of us, and her boyfriends always run off screaming after their first visit. Signed, Edward Munster. Boy genius. My father made me put that in.
Well, Edward, that's quite a composition. And thank you very much for staying after school and reading it for me. Oh, and we'll let you know what your grade is later on, hmm?
Does that mean I can cut out?
Cut out? Oh, yes, yes, Eddie, dismissed.
Good night, sir. Good night, Miss Thompson.
Good night, Eddie.
Miss Thompson, this is the most astounding composition I have heard in all of my years with the school system.
Yes, I thought it was a trifle unusual, Mr. Bradley.
Well, you were absolutely right in bringing this to my attention. course, we've always considered Eddie to be a little different ever since the day he first enrolled. In fact, I believe he is the only child in the entire fifth grade with pointed ears.
Why would he make up such wild exaggerations as this?
Oh, these problems usually start in the home. You know, if a child is unhappy or has an underprivileged home life, he's very liable to compensate by creating fantasies. You know, how wealthy his family is, what a great athlete his father is, stories like that.
Well, we just can't let Eddie go on like this.
Oh, you're right. You know, I think the way to get to the bottom of this is pay a little visit to the Munster family.
And you want me to call on?
Well, inasmuch as you are a rather new teacher, Miss Thompson, I'll tell you what. I shall go along with you. Then, in case anything unusual does happen, with my experience, it won't faze me, believe me. 9 feet tall, with a green complexion. You know, I will bet, in reality, that Mr. Munster is a short, unobtrusive little man who is afraid of his own shadow. But you know, this is very strange.
What?
This is written with the reddest red ink I think I have ever seen.
And if convenient, our principal, Mr. Bradley, and I would like to stop around after school to discuss Eddie and his composition. Sincerely, Miss Thompson.
Boy! A note from the teacher. You really made a big hit with that composition.
I'll bet you really made him sit up and take notice.
I'll say, when I read my composition to the class, all the kids started laughing and yelling and screaming and stamping their feet. A couple of them even doubled up so bad they had to be carried out of the room.
Strange the way jealousy affects some people.
Well, what did your teacher say, Eddie?
I guess it got her, too. She turned a little blue and choked a little, but when she got her voice back, she dismissed the class and had me read it to the principal.
Well, there's no doubt about it, kid. Your composition was a literary triumph.
You know what, Eddie? I'm going to make a point of leaving the parlor early today. I'll let Clyde handle my customers. I'm sure they won't complain.
I'll be home too, Eddie. I just love to meet your teacher.
Sure, Marilyn. I told her about you and my composition, so she'd be prepared.
I'll make some black sulfur tea and bake some coffin crullers and make some spider cookies and bat biscuits.
That's it, Lily. Lay out the festive board.
Would you guys do me a favor when the teacher and Mr. Bradley come?
Well, of course, Eddie. What is it?
Well, try not to embarrass me in front of them.
They embarrass you? How could we embarrass you?
Well, for one thing, Mom, don't tell them I'm your little baby and mushy stuff like that. And Grandpa, don't boast about how I have royal blood in my veins. I want to sound like one of the guys.
Don't you worry about us, Eddie.
And Pop, don't slap the teacher on the back and tell her any of your corny jokes.
Is it all right if I tell him the one about the sailor and the mermaid?
You tell him that one and I'll run away from home.
You just don't want me to sit there and look stupid, do you?
That'd be fine, Pop.
Don't you worry, Eddie. We promise that we'll be the soul of propriety and decorum. Oh, and by the way, Grandpa, if you're working down in the dungeon while we're having tea, please try not to blow up the house.
If it's that important to you, I'll make every effort.
I'm putting on the tea now, Aunt Lily, okay? Oh, yes, thank you, Marilyn. I'm just doing a little last-minute dusting. Dear me, the vacuum cleaner's working backwards now. Go and tell Grandpa.
Grandpa, the vacuum cleaner's running backwards.
Sorry, I turned the wrong knob.
Ah, that's better.
Hey, Mom, They'll be here any minute now. How do I look?
Oh, just fine, Eddie. Oh, did you wash up?
Sure. I brushed my fangs and washed behind my points.
You aren't a little nervous, are you?
No. But are you sure Pop won't tell any of his jokes?
I'm sure he won't.
Good. Because he's got a zinger that'd get me thrown right out of school.
Eddie, you put the vacuum cleaner away for me, and then be sure to listen for the door. I'm going into the kitchen and see to it that the cheese dip doesn't crawl out of the dish.
All right.
My. It's rather run down, isn't it?
Yeah. Just bears out my theory about an underprivileged childhood.
What was that big bird back in the yard?
That was a Neophron percnopteris. That is an Egyptian vulture.
What would he be doing here?
Well, let's just hope that he has a bad sense of direction. Miss Thompson, now this is liable to turn out to be a rather unusual visit. So whatever we hear or see in there, we must be very careful not to hurt the Munsters' feelings. May we come in?
Oh, sure. This is my cousin Marilyn. I told you about her, my composition.
Oh, yeah.
I guess you see what I mean.
I'm very happy to meet you.
How do you do?
Oh, won't you come into the living room?
We're gonna have eats.
Oh,
my niece is very charming. But have you ever seen such a house?
Perhaps their cleaning woman is ill.
I'll go get Aunt Lily. Won't you sit down?
It's okay. Everything was just dusted.
Oh. Mr. Bradley,
hmm?
Over there. Isn't that an electric chair?
Well, it could be the way the shadows are falling. It could be some of that pop art, too. Perhaps they're rather bohemian in their taste.
Here we are.
Mr. Bradley, she's green.
Malnutrition.
I'm Eddie's mother.
Oh, how do? I'm Mr. Bradley, and this is Eddie's teacher, Miss Thompson.
Won't you sit down?
Thank you.
Well, now, I guess you want to talk about my little baby here.
Oh, Mom, you promised.
Oh, I'm sorry, Eddie. He's such a sensitive child. Eddie, Spot's in the kitchen. Why don't you go and take him out in the yard and help him bury someone?
I get it. You want to talk about me. See you, Miss Thompson. See you, Mr. Bradley.
Oh, it's back.
Thank you.
Come on, Spot! Let's go!
Was that Spot?
Oh, yes, you'll have to excuse him. He has a little bit of laryngitis.
Have some cookies?
Oh, yes. Now, I don't think I'm as hungry as I thought.
Eddie's grandfather is quite busy, but I asked him to pop his head up and say hello.
Oh, good. That'll be nice.
Marilyn?
Now, Grandpa.
Pleased to meet you.
He's really very busy. We make our own electricity, you know.
Oh. It's very nice.
Now, I understand you were very impressed with Eddie's composition.
Oh, yes, we were, weren't we, Miss Thompson?
Hmm?
Impressed with Eddie's composition?
Yes.
Is something bothering you, Miss Thompson?
Well, yes, I could have sworn I saw something staring at me from that clock.
Thank you.
Oh, that's just our raven. He's such a busybody. But you can talk in front of him. He doesn't gossip.
No, Mrs. Munster, getting back to Eddie's composition, You know, there is one item that I do believe needs some clarification.
Oh? I thought it was all quite clear.
No. It was Eddie's description of his father. I mean, 9 feet tall, green complexion, and steel bolts in his neck.
Oh, that. Well, you see, many years ago...
Hello, everybody!
There's Herman now.
Now I'll throw the high voltage crossover.
Oh, isn't that annoying? Grandpa's blown another fuse. Herman, I'd like you to meet Miss Thompson over there and Mr. Bradley over there.
Oh, glad to meet you. Here, let me shake your hand.
Yeah, thanks.
What happened?
Something big and hairy just bit me on the wrist.
I told you to trim your fingernails.
I'll get Grandpa to turn on the lights. Grandpa, we're in the dark up here.
Keep your shroud on. I'll have the lights on in a minute.
Never mind about us. We have to be leaving right away.
Yes, we can discuss this any time.
Yes.
Oh, don't run. I'll go up and get the candles off Grandpa's slab.
That's a good idea.
Never mind. We can find our way out, I'm sure. This way.
Oh, isn't that a shame? And we were having such a nice little visit.
Just stick with me, Miss Thompson. You know, that door must be along here. Something.
Should we really run like this?
Now listen, if Munster looks anything like he sounds, I just don't want to be here when the lights come on. That's it.
Well, don't just stand there, Herman. Let's go out and show them to the door.
Yes, dear.
Mr. Bradley, we're in a car.
Oh, good heavens, we are.
Oh. There you are. Before you go, I want you to really meet my husband.
At last we meet. Face to face.
Don't faint until we get outside. It's been awfully nice knowing you.
Well, I certainly enjoyed our visit. Thank you.
You're very welcome.
My, what lovely people.
But all the time they were here, they just seemed so ill at ease.
Well, that's very understandable, Marilyn. You see, on a school teacher's salary, they don't very often get to ritzy joints like this.
Lucy, you're right. You're absolutely right. We never really did get acquainted with your teacher the other day. Did you extend her our invitation to come to dinner some night?
Yeah. Every time I ask, she turns white and changes the subject.
Well, son, I guess teachers work pretty hard. They're under quite a strain. They don't get too much time for social life.
Where's Grandpa this morning?
Oh, he's down in the lab. He gave up trying to make electricity. Now he's working on a water supply system so that we don't have any more water bills.
Hey, that sounds neat.
Yeah, but knowing your rotten old grandfather, he'll probably drown himself before he perfects it.
Now, I'll drop in my instant water pill and we'll have free water all over the house.
If this invention works, it'll be his greatest.
Hey, nothing comes out.
Just as I thought. Another failure.
Herman, aren't you going to do something?
Aren't I going to do something? Sit down.
breakfast.